Good day and welcome back. We'll talk about the beat and the Doppler effect. In this video, we will learn about how the beat is formed and about the phenomenon of Doppler effect. So first of all, beat is produced by the superposition of two sound waves with the same or slightly different amplitude and slightly different frequency. This results the production of beat, which is a type of sound that is periodically increasing and decreasing amplitude. Compared to the standing wave, the difference is the requirement of the input wave. Standing wave is produced by the superposition of two waves with the same frequency but travel in the opposite direction. The output sound of standing wave has constant amplitude at a certain point from the source. So now, let's observe the formation of beat. We have two waves of slightly different frequency, F1 and F2. When we superimpose both these waves, the resulting wave is as shown in this diagram. First thing to observe is that we have constructive and destructive superposition in different parts of the wave. This causes the high and low amplitude along the time, which is how the beat is formed. The frequency of this output wave is the average frequency of the input wave. Then, we can measure also the period by referring the two consecutive points where the constructive superposition takes place. We are not required to study about the derivation, but the beat frequency is the reciprocal of the period and also can be determined by the difference between F1 and F2. Another thing to notice is about the amplitude of the beat. Maximum amplitude is the sum amplitude of two input waves, while the minimum is their difference. So this is why the amplitude of the input wave is mentioned to be the same or only slightly different. Or else, the amplitude produced for destructive interference is not zero and the beat could not be detected clearly. To understand more about this, I prepared a short experiment for you to test it on your own, but you will need at least two devices or just open two tabs in your internet browser if you are using a computer. I will leave the steps in the description below, so just try it and see how the beat is formed. So now, let's try a trial paper question from Victoria Institution. We have a musical notes played simultaneously with a tuning fork of 512 Hz and there's beat of frequency 5 Hz. When we change to another tuning fork of 516 Hz, a lower frequency beat is detected. So the question is, what is the frequency of musical notes? As we have learned about the formula of beat, there are two possibilities. First is that the frequency of musical note is lower than the tuning fork, where we have 512 minus F is equal to 5 Hz. Second is the other way around. We have the frequency of musical note is higher, so F minus 512 equal to 5 Hz. Now, we shall analyze these two expressions. The frequency of tuning fork is increased from 512 Hz into 516 Hz. If the first equation is true, we shall expect higher frequency since we have a bigger number minus the frequency of musical note. For the second equation, since it is the frequency of musical note minus the bigger frequency, it should be less than 5 Hz and this is matched with what the question described. So we will reject the first equation and tack the second equation above to get the frequency which is equal to 517 Hz. We may try to substitute the value of F into the bottom equation to do verification. Now, we are going to talk about Doppler effect. It is the apparent change in frequency of sound due to the relative motion between the source and the observer. There are three cases to be discussed here. Let's see the default condition where both source and observer are stationary. So here, there is an ambulance which produces siren at a certain frequency, and let's consider the frequency of 1 Hz. The sound is produced at 1 wave per second and travel to the observer with the speed of sound which is around 300 meters per second. We could observe the wavelength, which is also the distance between the two waves here, can be obtained with the formula of S is equal to Vg. Hence, the distance between the two waves here can be expressed as V. So the frequency heard by the man there is simply just V over lambda. Now, let's see if the ambulance or the source is moving toward the observer with the initial velocity U. At the time of 1 second, the first wave produced at 0 second has traveled a distance of V, while the ambulance also traveled to a distance of U. The second wave is produced at this time, and we could see there is something fishy about the distance between the first and the second wave. The wavelength here is apparently shorter than the normal situation, and it could be expressed as V minus U, the distance traveled by the sound minus the distance traveled by the source. So those two waves will continue to move with the same speed, so the distance between two of them is constant after that. The process is repeating while the ambulance is approaching the man. In short, we could see that there is apparent wavelength which is shorter in this case and cause the frequency of the sound heard by the man is slightly higher than the frequency of the sound produced. So this is the apparent frequency and this is the Doppler effect. Now, let's derive the equation of apparent frequency. When the source is moving toward the observer, we have the apparent wavelength, which could be expressed as V minus U divided by the frequency. Using the formula of F equal to V over lambda, we can obtain the apparent frequency is equal to V over V minus U multiplied the original frequency. Another situation here is when the source is moving away from the observer. It is the opposite way. The apparent wavelength now becomes longer, so we have the wavelength is equal to V plus U divided by the F. Hence, the apparent frequency here is equal to V over V plus U multiplied the original frequency. Next, we will review the second case where the observer is moving toward the stationary source. The source produces the sound wave as usual, so we don't see any apparent wavelength. However, there is relative motion between the sound wave. Please take note, it is the sound wave, not the source. There is relative velocity between the sound wave and the observer, which is equal to V plus U when the observer is approaching the source. The sound seems going faster relative to the observer, so we have the apparent frequency is equal to V plus U over lambda, and then we can substitute the lambda is V over F. Finally, we could express the apparent frequency is equal to V plus U over V multiplied the original frequency. Move on to the opposite situation that the observer is moving away from the source. The sound seems slower to reach to the observer. Relative velocity is equal to V minus U. Repeat the derivation, and we have the apparent frequency here is equal to V minus U over V multiplied the original frequency. To conclude about the Doppler effect, the moving source can cause the apparent wavelength which affect the final frequency received by the observer. Then, the motion of observer result in the relative velocity between him and the sound wave and affect the final frequency. The third case is where both observer and the source are moving. So we just combine the formula derived just now, and this is the final formula for the Doppler effect. Now, let's try the question from trial paper of TERENGGANU in 2021. A train is approaching a person who is standing. We can understand that this is the first case of Doppler effect I have discussed. When the train is approaching the person, apparent frequency is equal to 630 Hz. So just apply the formula and we will have this first equation. Just remember, the wavelength will become shorter, so we'll use the minus sign in the equation of wavelength. Then, when the train is moving away, the apparent frequency is reduced to 580 Hz. So we'll use the plus and we will have this second equation. We have two unknowns and two equations here. So the next step is just solve it simultaneously, and you should be able to obtain the speed of the train is 12.4 meters per second, while the frequency of the sound produced by the whistle is equal to 604 Hz. We move on to the next question from the trial paper of SMJK CHUNG CONFUCIAN in 2021. We have a whale is fleeing away from an approaching fishbowl that produces a sonar with frequency 500 kHz. So this belongs to the third case. The fishbowl is approaching the whale with the speed of 10 meters per second. This gives us the apparent wavelength of 1500 minus 10 divided by the frequency of the sonar. Then, the whale is trying to run away from the fishbowl. We can see there is relative velocity between the whale and the sonar, 1500 minus the speed of the whale. So putting these two equations into the formula of F equal to V over lambda, we can obtain the speed of the whale is equal to 24.9 meters per second. Moving to the last discussion for today, a question from the past year in 2018. Ali is moving away from Zhong while moving towards the wall with the speed of 2 meters per second. He is blowing the whistle that produces a sound of 500 Hz. Now, we can see there are two observers here, Zhong and the wall. Between Ali and the wall, we shall apply the first case that the source is moving toward the observer. We can obtain the frequency of sound wave reaching at the wall is about 503 Hz. Next is between Ali and Zhong that the source is moving away from the observer. From here, we can calculate the apparent frequency is about 497 Hz. So now, the sound wave that reached at the wall will be reflected back to the left. John will receive two waves of different frequency that we have calculated. Hence, he will hear a sound that is periodically increasing and decreasing amplitude, which is the beat that we have learned in the beginning of this video. The beat frequency can be obtained by the difference between F1 and F2, which is equal to 6 Hz in this case. Before we end, let me give you a question to solve. Let's say the situation here is remain the same, except that Zhong is now running to the left with the speed of 2 meters per second. Calculate the beat frequency heard by Zhong. So I will give the answer for this question later in the comment section below. There is also another similar question in the trial paper of KOLEJ TINGKATAN ENAM PETALING JAYA in 2021. You may also try the question if interested, and the answer can be obtained from STPM Physics Telegram channel. So that's all for my discussion today. If you still have any question, leave it in the comment section below. Do leave a like and subscribe to my channel. I will see you in my next video. Thank you.